8 pro tips for editing professional long-term time-lapse. In editing a long-term time-lapse sequence into an interesting and engaging video, there are 4 challenges that you face. The first is changes in lighting, because you're taking photos that are different in time by minutes, by hours, by days, by months, even years. Your lighting conditions are going to change dramatically, day to day, month to month, season to season. And so for that reason, you end up with an enormous amount of what time-lapse photographers generally call flicker, which is where the lighting is changing between each photo. Challenge number 2 is what I call object flicker. So that's where objects are in one photo and then not in the next. So it may be a person, it may be a crane, it may be another construction vehicle, and they just come in and out of frame one photo to the next. And if you leave all that just as it is and stitch the photos straight together, it ends up like watching a strobe light. It's just non-stop object flicker and light flicker, and it makes it really unwatchable. The third challenge is stabilisation, especially if your camera's on a pole that's moved with the wind. Sometimes if it's on a metal pole, it heats up and contracts again with the sun moving the camera. And shot to shot, you just have some movement and you need to sort that out, because that can be quite distracting in the video. And the final challenge is to keep it interesting and hold the viewer's attention. We love long-term time-lapse, but even we understand that a single camera vantage point across the whole video may not hold viewers' attention. So what are you going to do to keep it interesting and make it an enjoyable watch for the full, say, 2 minutes? With these challenges in mind, I'm going to go through 8 tips for editing professional long-term time-lapse. Tip number 1 is cull photos. Cull, cull, and then cull some more. If you've watched our other videos, you'll know that we recommend when shooting long-term time-lapse to overshoot. Shoot way more photos than you need. And that's because with long-term time-lapse, there's going to be lots of photos you can't use. So they're going to be photos that are late in the evening or early in the morning, they're too dark. There may be some photos in the middle of the day where the sun's shining in winter that are too bright. There may be days where it rains, or even weeks long when it rains, that nothing really much happened on construction site. So for a whole range of reasons, there's going to be a whole lot of photos that you want to cut out, and now's the time to do that. Now the good news is there are ways to automate the filtering and the culling of photos, which brings me to point number 2. Use LRTimelapse to help you filter photos and to reduce flickering. LRTimelapse is a program designed specifically for time-lapse photographers with a particular focus on reducing flicker. It works hand in hand with Lightroom, and it is an absolute essential in your post-production toolbox when editing long-term time-lapse. The latest versions of LRTimelapse have a specific long-term time-lapse workflow, so you can just jump in and you can follow it step by step through the process. Gunther, who created LRTimelapse, has even done a video tutorial on how to edit long-term time-lapse using LRTimelapse, so I recommend you go and check that out. There are a couple of filtering tools in LRTimelapse that'll help you cull the photos that you don't need. The first is a brightness filter, and so you can set the parameters at a top point and a low point, and it will automatically filter out all images that are brighter or darker than the points you set. Secondly, it has a time of day filter, so it'll read the metadata of the photos, get the time of day each was taken, then again, you can set an endpoint, a start point, and say, get rid of all photos that aren't in that time range. With those 2 tools, you can quickly filter out photos that are outside your optimum brightness range. The other indispensable feature that LRTimelapse has, and the one that made it so popular for time-lapse photographers, is its deflicker tool. The deflicker tool brings the brightness of each photo closer to an average, and so you've got a much smoother sequence overall. LRTimelapse is a fantastic tool, and it should be an indispensable part of your toolbox for post-production for long-term time-lapse. If you take nothing else from this video, make sure you go and check out LRTimelapse. It is well worth the money you pay for it. Tip number 3, use After Effects to stabilize your footage. Now, as I said before, with long-term time-lapse, more likely than not, your camera is going to have moved back and forth throughout the project. If you find that most of the time it's stable and just 1 or 2 frames it's moved a bit, then you can just go in and move those single frames. However, if it's moving lots throughout the project, then you're going to want to use warp stabilizer. With warp stabilizer, it depends on the project and it depends on how much the camera moves as to the individual settings you use in warp stabilizer. The only way to work that out is to play around with the different options you have and work out what stabilizes your footage best. Tip number 4, work with the full resolution of the images right until the end when you drag it into your video editing program. When processing a long-term time-lapse sequence, you're going to be pulling the images all over the place. Into Lightroom, into LRTimelapse, into After Effects, back into LRTimelapse. But the key here is to make sure the whole way through you maintain the original resolution. That way, when it comes to editing your final video, you'll have plenty of resolution which you can use to zoom in and pan around the shot into the different details happening at different stages of the project. Tip number 5, to deal with object flicker, use frame blending. And you can do that in After Effects or LRTimelapse. The best way to deal with that object flicker that you get with a person or a vehicle being in just one frame is with frame blending. With After Effects, you can do that with CC wide time, and LRTimelapse has a frame blending option as well. There are different levels of frame blending in both those programs, and what you need to do is experiment with what level works best for your particular sequence. A quick tip on workflow, don't frame blend until after you've stabilized, otherwise bad things happen. Those first 5 tips were about best practice for editing your long-term time-lapse sequence. These last 3 tips are about how you can make the actual video you present to your clients a little more interesting. Tip number 6, look for periods of action. Not everything that happens on a construction site is equal for long-term time-lapse. For example, you may have weeks where all the electrical work is happening inside the building and nothing happens on the facade. Conversely, you may have periods where lots of action is happening on the outside. So, instead of just choosing for your long-term time-lapse photos from regular intervals across the whole project, go and look for periods of action. You can take more photos from the period that has more action on the outside, and then cut out photos where not much happens on the outside at all. Tip number 7, add some movement. If you've taken on board my previous tip about keeping your images in the full resolution right up to when you put it in the video editor, then you're going to have plenty of pixels to be able to zoom in and move around your image. And that can make for a much more interesting viewing experience. Particularly with large construction sites, there may only be action happening in small sections at any given time, and you can zoom in and pan around as that action happens. Now, you can either just do that with a simple pan and zoom, or you can add some 3D movement to make it look like the camera is moving through space to each of those places. Have a play around and see what works best for your project. Now, the 8th and final pro tip for editing long-term time-lapse is to spice it up with some other footage. Now, ideally, you would have thought about this at the start of the project and planned through the project to be taking B-roll. So it may be aerial of the construction site, it may be short-term time-lapse, it may be some slow motion footage of someone welding. Sparks always look pretty good in slow motion. It may be some talking head with investors or a project manager. Whatever you can get that you can cut into the time lapse to make it more interesting. That's one way to spice it up. Another way to make it more interesting is to use motion graphics. So for example, if you've got a high rise and it's going up at a steady rate, then you may have a motion graphic next to it that is counting the number of floors going up. There are a whole range of different stats and interesting information about the project that you could cut into the edit using motion graphics that'll make it for a much more interesting viewing experience. But here at photoSentinel, we're the experts at making long-term time-lapse equipment. You're actually the creative expert, so the question is really for you. What are you going to do to make your video stand out from the rest? What are you going to do to make your video interesting so that your client is really impressed? Take these 8 tips and add your own creative flair, and that's how you're going to get the best long-term time-lapse edit. Now, these tips are great for guiding you through step by step as you edit up your long-term time-lapse. But there is another way that you can automate a lot of that. At photoSentinel, we've taken those principles that I've talked about in this video, and we've used them to create a post-production tool called the Timelapse Generator, which is part of our cloud service. With the Timelapse Generator, you just need to click a few options, set a few parameters, and then it will do all the post-production for you. It will filter by time of day. It will filter by brightness, getting rid of images too light and too dark. It will do the frame blending. It will do dynamic range optimization. It will do the stabilization. And it does it all on really powerful computers on the cloud. So there's no more locking your own computer down as it does warp stabilization, as it exports photos, as it renders out your video. So your computer's free to do other things. And in fact, with the time-lapse generator, you can be generating multiple videos at once. You can generate videos with the time-lapse generator according to a predefined schedule so that you're delivering fully edited professional videos to your customers every week or every month, or you can generate videos just on a one-time basis when you need it. The time-lapse generator can be a huge time saver. We put a lot of effort into making it the best tool that it can be for photographers who are wanting to scale their long-term time-lapse business but don't have the capability to be doing all that post-production. So make sure you head over to our website to learn more about the time-lapse generator, have a look at some video examples of video that has been created by the time-lapse generator, and see whether it's a good fit for your workflow and your growing business.